Hey Siri, turn on voice control.
Okay, I've turned on voice control.
Go home. Swipe left. Swipe left. Go home. Swipe right. Open YouTube. Go home. Open settings. Go home. What's up guys, Tao here. One of the very, very interesting feature within the macOS Catalina is voice control. Now, there are some dictation features within the OS before Catalina. However, according to Apple, the new voice control within Catalina, you can control system-wide, not just the speech to text or just control certain apps. Now, today I will try to do a demonstration. There are a lot of commands in the system, and the machine still try to learn the way I speak, and also I'm just trying to remember the commands. There are some basic commands I will demonstrate. Hopefully you guys find this useful. For demonstration purpose, I have connected this 2015 MacBook Pro 13-inch to this monitor. Right now, my Hackintosh is still running on my Hovi, so it doesn't really have that voice control feature. So the Catalina on the 13 MacBook Pro has been updated, so therefore I'm using this. Right, to enable voice control, you need to go to System Preferences, and under Accessibility, there is an option called Voice Control, and then click on Enable, and then that will be enabled. Here you can see the language, United Kingdom. You can add the language, the microphone. Right now I'm using the internal microphone, or I think maybe better if you have a dedicated external microphone, maybe understand you better. But for now, I'll be using the internal microphone. Now, the other way to enable the voice control is by using Siri. Now, unfortunately, this 2015 MacBook Pro does not support Hey Siri. It doesn't listen all the time. According to Apple, only the 2018 MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, or the iMac Pro have a Hey Siri function, is listening all the time, 2018 or onwards. If your computer support Hey Siri, all you need to do is just Hey Siri turn on voice control, or Hey Siri turn off voice control. So you don't really need to touch the computer at all. But for this test, for this demonstration, I'll be using the mouse, because my MacBook Pro doesn't support it. Turn on voice control.
Okay, I've turned on voice control.
Show commands. Show commands. That's command. Open Safari. Click YouTube. Show numbers. 3. Show numbers. 21. Show numbers. 10. Close window. Open Microsoft Word. Show numbers. 11. Show numbers. 3. Hide commands. Hello. This is Tao M Studio. Full stop. Hello world. Hello world. I think I need to practice. Close window. Click don't save. It worked. Open calendar. Close window. Open launchpad. Okay. Go to desktop. Cancel that. Close window. Click. Show grid. Oh, hello. No. Hide grid. Quit calendar. Quit Safari. Quit Microsoft Word. Open Google Chrome. Show numbers. 19. Show numbers. 3. Sweet. Close window. This is awesome. Open system preferences. Show numbers. And let's see. Oh, no. Delete that. Click accessibility. Show numbers. 6. Move down. Move down. Scroll down. Click voice control. Click. Show numbers. 22. Open Siri. What's the weather like today?
Here's the forecast for today.
Oh, right. Close Siri. Voice control is fantastic. It's a bit exhausting at the beginning to use it, but after a while, once you get your head around it, once you remember the commands, and then you are ready to rock and roll. Oh, it's dictating what I'm saying right now. All right, that was the basic demonstration of voice control. There are loads other commands you can use, and there are loads of commands you have to remember in order you to take full advantage of the voice control. I think you can control the entire computer just by using voice. Now, in terms of turn on the voice control, you can always turn on, so every time you restart a computer, it's always there. Now, if you don't have voice control turned on by default, if you have one of those 2018 MacBook Pro or newer, you can use Hey Siri. Now, Siri is one of the better ways to enable or disable the voice control if you have compatible devices. One of the main reasons I want to get the message out is to raise awareness of the accessibility. And there are so many people out there who can't physically use the mouse, who can't physically use a touchpad or trackpad. Now, voice control is, I think, is one of the best functions you can use to use day-to-day tasks. Honestly, I'm just did a very simple demonstration. There are a lot of potential out there. So please get a message across to your friends, your family, if you know somebody who has physical limitation to use the keyboard and the mouse, let them use the voice control, let them see how they get on. So I think it has very, very good potential. All right, this is it. Thank you very much for watching. If you like the video, please click on the like and share with others. So hopefully others will see the benefit out of this video as well. See you in next video. Honestly, this is fantastic. I think voice control could be a game changer.